songs are perfect when we gather to worship God in song. Simple and profound, short and long, second-person songs, third-person songs. And we need different kinds of songs to express different kinds of responses. Sometimes our response will be awe and amazement. Sometimes it will be passionate and joyful. Other times it will be expressing sorrow for sin or humility that expresses our need for God's grace. Sometimes it's just a constant, steadfast faith in the midst of severe suffering and trial.
Well,
with some exceptions, the modern repertoire is woefully short on those kinds of songs, songs of lament, songs that help us process grief and suffering together.
Leave him alone.
I've got a good idea.
At one point in our church life here in the Southern Baptist Church of Louisville, we had a dearly loved husband and father die in a tragic car accident on a Thursday. We had to meet that Sunday. And we had a plan for Sunday, but we changed it. And I was grateful that we had songs that we could sing for those moments. Songs like "Be Still My Soul," "God Moves in a Mysterious Way," or one we didn't do that Sunday, but it's very relevant.
No.
"Jesus, I My Cross Have Taken." The point is, we need all kinds of songs to express all kinds of perfect responses. Now, this affects not only the songs we choose, but the way we arrange them. It's totally appropriate to use a full band. Again, we tend to fall into ruts and just do every song with the same instrumentation. That's going to help us engage with a variety of emotions. But we might use a full band one time. Another time, we might just use an acoustic guitar. Sometimes we might use just piano and organ. Or if you have the resource, you might want to use a string quartet. The important thing to remember is this. Worship is not a sound. It is hearts and lives responding to the grace we've richly received in Christ. And there's an extraordinary diversity in how that looks and sounds in our churches and showings. So here is the third way that music serves the word. Music can help us engage with words in unity. Singing together is a unifying experience. It doesn't matter where you do it. Football games, birthday parties, weddings, concerts. You know, we don't gather together just to recite or shout words. Singing enables us to spend time communicating the same thoughts, passions, and intentions together. Now, our singing doesn't have to be congregational.